Hello students of class 7, hope you're all doing well. So today we will be giving revising some of the sums from exercise 6. Previously we have discussed some of the sums from exercise 5. Now we will discuss some of the sums from exercise 6. Okay, so first I am doing sum number 4b, where it has been asked to find out the fourth proportional, right? So the first three are given, we are need to find the fourth one. So we will consider, let the fourth proportional be x. Therefore we can write the proportions as 15, 30, 16, x. So how will we write that? And 15 by 30 is equals to 16 by x, right? So this will go here, that is 15x, and this will go here, that is 16 into 30. So x will be how much? It will be 16 into 30 by 15, and this will cut and it will become 32. So the value of the fourth proportional is how much? It's 32. Okay, so I think this is clear. So now we will be discussing sum number 5c. Okay, 5c, where we have been asked to find out the third proportion. So we again we will consider the third proportion as x. So let the third proportion be how much? Be x. So we can write the proportion as 25, 30, x. So how will we write that? 25 by 30, it's a continuous proportion, so the value of this and this will be same. This will be like this, right? So this x will go here, that is 25 x 30 into 30. So the value of x will be 30 into 30 by 25. So if I cut it with 5, this will be 5 and this will be 6, and if I again cut it, will be 1, it will be 6. So the value is how much? 6 into 6, that is 36. So here the value of the third proportional is 36. Okay, so just you need to know how should we write the proportion. Okay, so if you know that, then half of the sum is done. Okay, so just keep it in your mind that how should we write the proportion. Okay, and what value should be considered as x. Okay, now we will consider, we will have to find out, we will do the sum number 6b. Okay, 6b, where we have been asked to find out the mean proportion. Okay, now again for the mean proportion we will consider the, let the mean proportion be x. Okay, so we can write it as 14, x, 56. Now in this case x is in the middle, so the x will repeat, right? Repeat. So it will be, so we can write it as 14 by x equals to x by 56, right? So this will get here and this will go there. So 14 into 56 is equals to x into x is x square, or we can write it as x square is equals to 14 into 56, right? So how much is 14 into 56? It's, I think, 14 into 56 is 784. Okay, it's 784. And okay, it's x square is how much? is 784. Now we need to find the root of 784, right? Square root. So what is the square root of 784? It's 18, I think it's 18. No, 18 is 324. I think it's 28. Okay, so if you do the prime factorization of 784, you will get x square, x is equal to how much? Root over of 784. And if you do the prime factorization of 784, you will get the value of x as 28. So the mean proportion is how much? It's 28 out of here. Okay, so these are the three process how to find out the fourth proportion and then the third proportion and the mean proportion. So I have done all of the three types. I hope all of the sums are clear. Okay, so this much for this video. Thank you.